Hi, I'm out of darts. This week I've got a new project update on the HIRricane. This is the HIRricane 2.0. A few months back I got a 3D printer and my first priority was to work on 3D printed parts for the HIRricane. I'll share the 3D printing experience in another video because it's been really interesting and really frustrating at the same time, but we'll talk about that later. So here's my final design. I've worked hard to make this as sleek as possible. I wanted to really bring all of the parts a lot closer to the actual blaster, and that way the center of gravity would be a lot better. This current version holds now only 90 rounds, but I find that it doesn't stick as far out of the back and out of the front as it did before. I've made a little insert here at the top, and it has a little magnet, so I have this little clamshell door, which stays closed with a neodymium magnet. The rest of the parts are kind of standard PLA 3D printing. On the back side, I printed my name and the magwell. I've replaced the magwell itself here with 3D printed parts. That way, I didn't have to cannibalize an actual magazine for future versions of the design. Additionally, I've 3D printed a plate up here on top to replace the original sight rail because it gets in the way of this tube. And when you're shooting down this, you kind of have the tube to aim with anyway, and sights are not so useful in Nerf guns, so I feel like it's not a big loss. Overall, I think the aesthetics are so much better than they used to be. This thing is rock solid. The whole tube set is held in place by a custom designed mag feed, and that mag feed back here actually clicks into place with the stock holding mechanism. The wiring inside is pretty much the same. I've done a full auto mod on it, just like a Drac or wood piece, and this one doesn't have the solenoid, so it's a completely mechanical trigger, just so I have variety around. The main wiring thing that I have changed, however, is that the rev switch and the on-off switch here now control different things. The rev switch only revs up the actual blower itself, while when you turn the front switch on, you get both the blower and the flywheels. This is really nice because you don't have to sit there revving both of them just to load the mechanism. Drac and a few others had asked, you know, how the heck do you load this thing? And really, it's quite simple. You just turn off the flywheels and you rev that part. Obviously, you don't want to leave them open, but you drop them in and let them feed through. So while I'm at it, I guess I'll go ahead and fire it. So it flows better than ever. I've got the voltage on the fan running at about 22 volts, and it seems to hold up just fine. One other modification you can notice right off the bat when you see is the profile. I've inverted the blaster and cut a hole in the side of the blaster so the fan can sit in here. I felt that it looks a lot better than it used to, and it just has a lot sleeker profile. And then when you're holding it up to your face, you don't have this big fan right in the front of your vision. Thanks for taking a look at this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Please subscribe for future updates. It really helps me know that there are people out there watching this. My next project in probably a couple weeks to a month is a really unique Apollo mod, and I think people are going to get a kick out of it, but I'm not going to say any more at this point. Until next time, I'm out of darts.